What is going on, guys? We are back with another video today, and we are doing a blast from the past that I've wanted to do for quite some time now, and that is basically quite possibly the best pass rush duo ever. There's definitely top three, but quite possibly the number one pass rush duo ever. When you put those two fellers' stats together, it's pretty amazing. Of course, they weren't always together, but I'm pretty sure they racked up right around 200 sacks combined while playing on the same defensive line overall in their careers. If they played all their games together, they would have combined for just about 250 sacks. They were a duo to be afraid of, without a doubt. Who was better? I mean, the jury's still out on that. I would probably say I liked Freeney more, but Mathis was a bit more consistent, so it's a tough one to grade. Long story short, let's get into the players we made. So I made them the exact same overall, and they're very similar in play style, so that's what I decided to give them. This is Dwight Freeney, a bit faster in his prime, technically. Now, for the abilities, I wanted to do something like spinner, because obviously that was, where the hell is it? That was literally what he was known for. However, from what I can understand, I don't think there's actually a way to physically spin. You know, I'm still going to give it to him and just hope that spinning with the analog stick like you would if you were using a running back works. But unstoppable force, under pressure, and spinner. Once again, the ratings, the traits, all looking really solid. Stamina, I don't know why there was some leakage. I got to pay attention to this. I always say leakage because I'm pretty sure that's what it's called. What is it called? I don't know if it's a data leak, but it's something where like the game's like maybe a packet leak. I don't remember, but the game just like doesn't register stuff, so you lose your stats for whatever reason. Your ratings adjustments, this happened to me quite a bit. It happened a lot in that offensive lineman ultimate guide thing, which I recommend you guys actually go check out if you haven't. Now here's Robert Mathis, his build. I want to make him younger. I think he was slightly younger, right? I think he was like a year younger than Dwight. I'm pretty sure he's like a year younger than Dwight. Looking at Robert Mathis, of course, like I said, with the build, very similar in build, but a bit slower. Excel's still pretty good. Traits, a little bit less traits. As far as abilities, unstoppable force, under pressure, and then edge threat. Maybe could have went with something here, but I like what we have going on here. And I think we're going to play one of the first teams right out the gate, the Jaguars. I want to find a team that doesn't run the ball that much, though. It's like Jacksonville wouldn't be a team that I would think of that would pass all that much. Let's take a look at the schedule before we do anything. You actually look at this schedule, and it actually is kind of like all rushing teams. Jacksonville is like 50-50. Chicago in-game doesn't like the... We're going to go against Chicago, I think. Chicago in-game doesn't really like to run the ball too much. Their ratings, their stats are pretty low, and Trubisky's won MVP quite a bit during rebuilds, so I think it's fair to go to the Chicago Bears, and then outside of that, maybe the Green Bay Packers, but their offensive line is a little bit too good for my liking. But let's go into it and play the Chicago Bears. I suppose kind of a potential revenge game for Chicago as well. And it's a little bit of a rainy one. I mean, I don't know how this is going to affect it, but if they run the ball a lot out the gate, maybe we back out and redo it, but whatever, right? Whatever. It should help us, actually, because they're going to get a little bit slower off the line, and that's a bit of a yikes at quarterback. Oh, no. What a disaster. Oh, was that not Freeney? If that was Freeney, that would have been filthy, but it wasn't, so forget it. I can't use it in both at the same time, obviously, so... At this point in time, we're going to just kind of filter between each. What the hell did I play? Well, that's a little unfair because Mathis kind of got cucked a little bit, as apparently Darius Leonard was the... Get in there. Darius Leonard was the sub pass rusher, so there's that. Love it. Hey, I forgot they have Buckner on this. Imagine. Let's see if we can try to do a spin. Aha! It does work. I'm glad we did do it. As Dwight, they're going to get a lot of time to pass there. I mean, absolutely smoked it, right? Like, Dwight Freeney did a really good job there, but Too many players to break off. All right, bring him down. Third and two. Come on, Mathis. And can't get over there in time. I like to see Dwight get in there. Dwight looking pretty. I mean, I like the way we built these players. You know, typically we do pretty good with them, but I don't know what you guys think. And they are kind of like running heavy here a little bit. Let's go the power move this time. Actually, let's go spin again. And really good coverage there, fellas. Gotta love it. Tried to do a spin, and it's picked off by Blackman. I don't know if he got scared or what's the story. Can we get one of the pass rushers involved? No. All right, well, we're back on defense, I guess. Man coverage. I'm going to use our Blackman here. I'm going to see the AI's work or not. He cuts it back into danger. Why? Yeah, Freeney's already, like, my favorite player to use. The spin word, but we got into danger. We're going to go off the edge. That did not work at all. Trying to spin with Dwight is, it's been a little bit of a nightmare so far. I ain't gonna lie. Mathis shedding off of everyone. Kind of getting a piece of it. Maybe. We're back to Dwight again. This time I think we're gonna go with the swim move inside. Oh, we're a little slow there. Swim move outside, actually. And another inside play. You going against two? Oh, you had to run away as Mathis crushed it. Oh, he's got him. We missed. No. No. We forced the issue. No. At least Mathis gets half of it. That would have been like potentially the best thumbnail. We got a speed spin move. That was beautiful. Beautiful work. Gotta love when it ends in a punt. Right, Dwight. Oh, that's too easy. Mathis already kind of outperforming Dwight early in this one. People are like, that's because you're using Dwight the whole time. And you know what I say to that? You're not wrong. Another spin move. Where is the coverage? What? What are we doing? The hell's happening here? Come on, boys. This is all Mathis. That spin move. No. Buckner's going to get it. We got, like, double team, dude. Come on, man. Oh, we also, just for the fun of it, may or may not have turned off roughing the passer. Just for a little extra fun. As you can tell, as we assaulted him. The hell is Freeney doing? I mean, I know these two liked each other, but jeez, man. Oh, my God. Once again, double teamed. Huge hit on Anthony Miller. That will be a punt. Oh, Rodrigo Blankenship may or may not have missed the kick. What a useless. Oh, come on. Come on. How do people pass rush? It's illegal. It's a crime. Where's Dwight? I got kind of pushed inside. You know, I'm changing the plays up, too. I just want a nice spin move Dwight Freeney sack. Then he can just live his life out as anything. Oh, that's so good. Like, you can't even ask for anything better than that. Like, that's just beautiful. Oh, I'm a salesman. Oh, come on, dude. I get so excited. Because it's like the AI almost always gets rid of it in time. But, of course, I... sale. Oh, the spin move doesn't work for him, though. Lockdown. I think we're just going to run man press. A press man every time. And just hope that works, because it seems to work, kind of. Dwight causing issues. Hit as he's thrown. I mean, Mathis and him definitely caused that to be short, but I just want to see the actual sackaroo. Oh, did they go for that? Yeah, we went against a pretty good team for this, because their tackles suck. Oh, they actually stopped the spin move, and what a catch on third and six. By one of the best receivers in the league, Allen Robinson. Severely underrated. Inside, Robert. Once again, I have no idea if any of these would be considered a late hit, but I don't care because I turned it off. Dwight! Oh, no. Dwight got steamrolled by Mathis, though. Come on. Let's just use a speed rush. Oh, what is this? Oh, wow. He is so fast. Oh, my. Oh my, he's fast. I'm glad we tuned in for this absolute barn burner, by the way. Let's try to just use a straight up speed move with Freeney. If it doesn't work, we're going to use the spin. Oh my lord, did you even... I've watched Dwight Freeney and Mathis play quite a bit of football. That was prototypical Freeney. I mean, just absolute, like his bread and butter. Use the speed to get him far out there and then use his own weight against him because he's, you know, backloading that right leg and just spins him out of this universe. Oh my god, I'm so glad we did the spinner thing. Let's try it again. Of course, this is going to be a run. Oh, and he gets him with the spin. Oh, he gets him with the spin. The spin is brutal. Oh, there goes Buckner. That's just... Oh, man. Imagine those three actually playing at the same time. That would be unfair. And we're not getting the statistics, but we are burning them. And like I knew I was going to want to use Freeney more than Mathis. Not that Mathis isn't great, but... Damn, look at Patterson go. It's just the spin move, man. We're going to press again. We're going to go for the speed rush, and then we're going to spin inside, and we're going to crush him. I got excited. That's my fault. Doesn't matter because they go for the instant throw again. Actually driving me nuts at this point. Double teamed. Perfect coverage. Still catches it. Dwight Freeney baiting in the inside. Oh, that's a touchdown. I don't know why I'm even using that anyways. Instant throwing every time. Man coverage with a press. It doesn't matter what it is. They instantly throw it to the inside. That's all the AI does. Use your Mathis this time. Oh, we dove. That one, I feel like you had to dive. I don't know what the hell Foles is doing there. I thought he had the dump off, so we dove to try to grab him, and we missed. But, like, that is, like, that one, I could admit, isn't necessarily my fault. There we go. Good job, Freeney. Oh, there you go. That's the pressure. Under pressure. It's not showing it on the bottom of the screen for some reason, but that's clearly an under pressure one, right? Another blitz. No one on the running back. Figured we'd be fast enough, and kinda. Gonna use the speed rush and then the spin in. Ah, they got me. I don't get it. I don't understand how they're throwing the ball so quickly. Like, what? Is this... Are we glitching the game somehow? Like, we're burning so quick that the game just can't keep up? Oh, look at Dwight! And there's just no one on him! I mean, somebody's out of here. Dwight just had three players on him. Damn, really? Look, I mean, look at this. Like, what am I watching? Oh, Mathis. That's a Mathis play. Burned two players, and a third was having to, like, engage inside and opened up so well. I think a club over to the right now. We're going to go to the right. Oh, look at the speed. Like... The defense getting crushed has nothing to do with Mathis and Freeney. They are getting to the ball almost immediately. And the two guys kind of collapse the line and stop them to fourth and inches. Here it is. See if they can do something. Oh, there's no way Dwight just missed that. Of course, he did enough to slow it down, but how? I will say, in this game, I have noticed, especially when I play against people, behind the line of scrimmage, what is it called? I might as well go for this. I want to give them a chance to go to OT. Behind the line of scrimmage, like hit sticks or tackles, they bounce off a lot. We taking a shot here. Is that macaroni? Holy crap, he almost caught that. Maybe that's why they got rid of Fuller. It's not. They literally, it was just all money, but still. Might as well say it's the reason. And once again, oh my god, I sold. But did you see the move Mooney just put on him? Oh my lord, just like their throw is literally insta passes. And hit as he's thrown. Great defense. Great defense over there. And we do get the pressure. The ball is almost right, thrown right to Malik. We're so screwed. Like, look at this. Huge hit. We're getting torched. That's all I can tell you. Off the edge. I mean, a field goal wins it, so you would have thought by now they probably would have went for that. Oh, lordy. Let the eyes work. And once again, that little freaking stick play to the tight end. Even when I shade that way, gets burned. Willis trash. Buckner's just not having it. All right, we're going to need to force a fumble here. And maybe our guys get in there, but no fumble. And we hit him. Oh, that would have been clutch to pick that. Extend overtime. Well, not extend it, but, you know, give another drive. All right, here it is. The moment. No one's been waiting for it all. Do we have, like, Dwight or someone on that? Freeney, could you imagine? No way. And we don't. Damn, dude. That was an interesting one, to say the least. Colts offense got to be, like, the most garbage offense ever, by the way. The way they played was just disgustingly bad. Of course, sack totals, Mathis and Freeney didn't really combine for much, but that's because the Colts coverage was just selling. I do not know what the hell happened in that one. So strange. Of course, we got a lot of power moves or a lot of moves in, a lot of spin moves and whatnot. I mean, the two were dominant. It's just, of course, statistically, they didn't get it done because, you know, EA just codes the game to be perfect inside passers no matter what you do. But yeah, we're going to end up going to the playoffs and seeing what the two can do on the season. Back in 04, I believe they combined for near 28 sacks, if I'm not mistaken, which is obviously very impressive. And the Colts made the playoffs at 9-7, not with any help from us, I'll tell you that. Defensively, what do we have? Freeney looking pretty good. Freeney at 16 and Mathis only at 6. I did forget to... Well, we're going to do another season, actually. I did forget to... What is that called? I forgot to put him in the sub spot, which I don't understand why the game doesn't just like know to do that. Defensive player of the year, Freeney at number 4, unfortunately. Probably the best pass rusher, though. Nope, number 2. So we're going to go on another season. I would assume... Well, let's first see if they, you know, make the playoff or win the Super Bowl out. And they don't, of course. Let's see what happens if we actually sim it again with him in the right spot. Because as you know, you got otherworldly pass rushers. You'd rather not have him at sub. Of course, let's take a look at their contract. So a 4-year 85 for Dwight and a 5-year 124 for Mathis, which is very interesting because I'd probably rather have Freeney long-term considering the speed difference. Speed and size, of course. I know the height's not as good, but the weight. We re-sign him. That's all that really matters. Let's go on to the next season. And actually put them in the right spot and see what happens. All right, in the wild card again. You know, pretty much the same record this time. I don't know if I've ever seen Matt Barkley start for a team, by the way. Looking at the redo. And Dwight Freeney's still the dude on top. Looking at the, you know, snaps played. Very similar. Robert Mathis, it's very ironic because these numbers are actually almost very similar to that 2004 season. But yeah, 10 sacks, 15.5 for Dwight. 12 tackles for loss, 7 there. As far as like forced fumbles go, none. None at all. A safety by Mathis, though, which is pretty impressive. Any shot? Any shot or no shot? Any shot or no shot? No shot. Where the hell is, like, not even on the list? For real? Ah, AFC. Yep. I don't know why I thought it was... Yep. Don't worry. Nah, don't talk about it. Am I missing something here? It's like, it still doesn't matter. Freeney at 3. Mathis at 10. God, my brain. I don't know why I thought of the Giants for some reason. I think I was thinking of, like, doing another one for Tuck and OC. I think that's why. I think that's secretly why I did. I thought of that in my head. That's what I'm going to tell my kids, at least. And, of course, I don't know why we would care, but, you know, they don't make it. Super Bowl, boom. Ravens over the Niners in the rematch. Anyways, thanks for watching. If you guys enjoyed this one, maybe leave a like, subscribe if you're new. Follow me on Twitter, Jeromepkr. Second channel, PKR Plays, twitch.tv/Jeromepkr for streams. And then, also, let me know if there's any blasts in the past. Players, teams, career resims, how long did it take an NFL team to win the Super Bowl, anything at all, let me know in the comment section below, and that's pretty much it. Should be another video later today. Hopefully you guys enjoyed. Hopefully come back for next video. But until next video, see ya!